fidelity. You can't ask me to do that. It's against my faith.
It is not against mine, Ezinne. It is the tradition of our people. Look, I just want to be sure that you're not going to break my heart.
Of course I won't. You don't trust me.
No, not that. Of course I trust you, but look, Ezinne, a man's heart can be deceptive sometimes. Okay? Look, I love you, Ezinne. You are my world right now, and I want both of us to live in it forever. Look, so just do this for me, my love, eh? And it will kill my fears and worries forever.
Adim wants Ezinne to go to his family shrine and swear an oath that she would never cheat on him.
Are you serious?
See, I'm not. This is not my problem with all these men.
Because they know your life history, they think you'll be a prostitute to the end of time.
I'm just so weak.
Did you admit to it?
No, 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 can't do that. You're a Christian.
This kind of thing backfires.
Dennis cannot try it with me. He cannot even. I would just have bought this baby one time.
You're pregnant?
You're pregnant.
Opike! Owunje! Umi feji dofo. Say after me. Any day I sleep with a man.
Any day I sleep with another man.
May the gods strike me mad. Yes.
May the gods strike me mad.
Okuru cheta. Aso aso aye. Gina edemu ye ke.
Opi ke.
Fidelix, I want you to be honest, very honest. If you were the one, would you do that to the woman you love?
Well, Angeline, I don't know, but I mean, these are two people who are in love, and I'm sure they came to a compromise before taking that decision. It's not for us to judge. I mean, you know what love can do.
I, for one, do not buy that idea.
Our opinion doesn't count here. I mean, this is husband and wife, and they have decided to do this. It's not our business. It's not supposed to be.
Yes.
Where have you been?
Let's get the confirmation you asked. I'm pregnant and 2 months gone. Why would you go take an oath?
Look, Kiria, I'm tired of all of you being all up in my business. Adim is my husband, and he did the same for me, so what the heck?
That's not the case here. It's not an act Christians should indulge in. I don't like it, and I cannot pretend about it. Simple. I just don't like it.
The deed has been done. It makes my family happy. And I'm happy too.
Adim, listen, this girl is not going to use this pregnancy to make me marry her. But if I have to marry her, I will. This shouldn't be a by force thing.
You know, your reasoning sometimes baffles me. Here is a girl you've been dating for a long time now. You've been having sex with her, and now she is pregnant. And suddenly, she's not good enough as a wife material.
Oh boy, that's not the issue. This girl, not only is she a runs girl, as you know, she's a klepto. You remember the first time I met her, it was in a supermarket. She was nearly raped because she stole. What are people going to say?
What difference does it make? Ezinne, is she not her friend? They come from the same background. But you encouraged me to go for her.
Can't compare the two of them. You cannot. Ezinne might be a street girl too. But she has her own training, man.
And Kiria doesn't have.
Kiria doesn't. Kiria doesn't. Not only is Kiria a street girl, she's flippant, she steals. I mean, with all those attributes, it's clear that she's not made of wife material, bro.
So, bros, why did you do it without a condom?
Sitting on a keg of gunpowder by living with a man.
outside wedlock.
Chief.
Yes.
For your information, I have done an oath with this man of fidelity. He is mine forever and I am his. Just go.
Ezinne, this is foolish wisdom. It is like serving poison in a gold plate. Oh my God. You see, the crab has two heads. So that if you cut off one, it can survive with the other. So why? This is absolutely wrong, isn't it? Why?
Because of men like you that cannot keep their eyes off me. Please, Chief, you have... Just go. You have been very good to me. I don't want you to say as if I'm insulting you or anything, Chief. But I am married.
Necessary, you know, contacts today. So, what is left is for me to go to the bank tomorrow, change the money to dollars, and then wire it to my importer. Mm. Done.
I'm really happy for you. You're back in business. Well, I hope that this time around, right contact.
Yeah. No. This guy is real. He used to be my importer, based in China, before I met this 419 guy, you know, so I'm sure everything will go well.
I'm so happy for you.
All thanks to you. You know, you're a godsend to my life.
Listen, Kira, you don't need to cry about it. Tears won't solve any problem. All I'm saying is that pregnancy before marriage is not accepted in my family. My parents won't find this funny.
Do you have to make a public announcement of it to your people? I mean, it's not showing yet.
How about our conscience? You're a Christian, I'm a Christian. Listen, our faith doesn't accept this.
But your faith accepts abortion, right?
I think you're getting too far with this. All I'm telling you is I don't want this rush thing of pregnancy. I'm not ready for it now. You understand? Let's take this slowly. You abort that baby and then we'll take things gently.
You know what? Fidelis, just say it, okay?
Say what?
Just come out straight. Be a man. Say it to me. Say it. You don't want to marry me. Just say it, okay? Fidelis.
What?
Get out!
Hey.
Get out!
Take it easy.
What? Get out!
Realize I've been waiting for 1 hour now. Have they not finished their counting?
Please, I'm not sure. How much will you count for the
records? What kind of money are they counting? For over an hour?
Sorry.
Good afternoon. Is your bus now ready with my money?
Yes, ma'am. This way.
All I said was for her to abort the pregnancy, so her, my family, as well as hers, wouldn't be disappointed.
Fidel, pregnancy is a thing of joy. If you wanted to marry her.
Ezinne, I never promised her marriage. For goodness sake, why is everybody breathing down my throat about this?
Fidel, I am very, very disappointed. It's so unfair and curious, you know.
Really? You know what? There's nothing I can do about this.
The fact is, I don't want pregnancy before marriage, period.
But you want abortion before marriage?
Ezinne, I know Kiria is your friend, but this is my life. Can you guys allow me to run things here?
Exhausted their money actually. They don't even have enough currencies for me. But I can change for you. That is if you wish to. So, how much do you wish to change?
2 million. 2 million naira.
2 million?
Yes.
Pounds or dollars?
Dollars.
Dollars?
Yes.
Right.
Okay.
Money.
Yes.
Please change the equivalent of 2 million naira into dollars for me. Please collect my cash. Have a nice day. And be fast.
Sure.
I can't eat this food. I think we should start our life afresh. I think a lot has happened in our lives that we all need to learn from.
I think so too. I really do. But what do I do in my pregnant state and Fidel is refusing to marry me?
Kiria, this is not the end of the world. I think we should use the money we've saved, start a small business, anything, and become productive to ourselves. All these men, bronze, they are not worth the stress.
You know, I'm beginning to think Ezinne is extremely lucky to have found a man who married her against her odds. I'm serious. And, do you think I should abort this baby?
No. My friend, abortion is not an option. You don't know what this baby may mean to you. This baby is going to bring you joy, happiness. This baby may be something in the future. It's going to bring you so many blessings to your doorstep. Don't think about aborting it. Let's just think of the business to start up so that we could be productive instead of depending on all these men for money.
Thank you. Good afternoon.
How are you? Do you mind if I give you a ride? You see, with the kind of money you have there, you should be more security conscious. You know what I mean?
Oh, yes, yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right.
They kept counting and counting and counting. And I was just waiting there. I said, where are they taking all this money to?
And then this woman just came in. If you see this woman, pretty woman with all the attitude, you know? Man, I never believed that there's such a rich woman in this country. She had her own bodyguards, you know? And they were cutting money in and out of the office.
Wow. Are you serious?
I'm telling you, you know? You know, she even offered to change my own 2 million for me. You see, man, in this country, who will believe see that kind of woman in this country will get that kind of money? And guess what? She gave me a ride to your office.
Wow, serious?
Which one you did?
Which one are the Yan Yu Beta Gist? Say the knack calculator. Bah, bah, bah.
Oh boy, please, I beg no vex. I needed to sort out this fast. I have a client coming.
Lunch. Now.
Once I'm able to pay for these goods, eh?
It's going to be wonderful, man.
At least you get back to your legs, huh?
Yes, man. I need to wake up from it.
What else?
Oh, God. My wife's savings. My wife's savings. 1 million naira. Gone.
So,
am I on that course?
I need to wake up from this. What is the meaning of this?
Good
bad. You'll be fine. Look, God is our strength. He will see us through. In Jesus' name.
Seriously, I sympathize with you, but I warned you. With that kind of money on you, anyone could have trailed you, even from that exchange office. So, what do you wish to do now?
I don't know. I don't know. I'm really so confused now.
You see, Adim, very handsome man. I liked you immediately I saw you at that office. You see, 2 million naira is chicken change to me. I can help you, but do you wish I help you?
Well, I will really appreciate that.
Okay, very well then. I will give you the money. But I am a businesswoman and I do not trust men one bit. So you are going to sign for me when you are going to return the money with interest.
With interest?
Meaning of my name now.
Oh! We're not two in this world.
3 mil!
3 M.
3!
Oh boy! That's you! Man, I'm happy for you, bro. I'm happy. I think this woman, well, you know what? This lady must be a godsend. She's another godsend. I'm telling you.
You can say that again.
You know, they say in life, to every disappointment is a blessing. This is your chance. Do it.
Wait, let me get to the bank first and cash this.
That's it, bro.
Then we will know.
No, you'll catch it. You said she was packing money in bags. Even eat my food.
Listen, I suggest you should take it to him yourself, okay? Alright? You know, he just got a new job. And I guess he might be the stress out of the business to just start it. Good woman, a good wife, and God will continue to bless you.
Amen.
My daughter, I'm glad you came to me first, not your mom. Yes. A wise woman built her home, while the foolish one scattered it. Because men see different issues in their business every day. And most times it is us, their wives, that they will transfer it to, knowing fully well that we will worry for them.
He doesn't even talk to me. Call his phone and he doesn't even pick up the phone.
It's okay.
He comes back home really late.
Hey, my dear. No, don't worry. Just give him time. He will come back to his senses. Okay?
Oh, all I ask him for is that he talks to me, tells me his problem.
Don't worry.
I am his wife.
It's okay, my daughter. It's okay. He will change. You know, man. They will always prove that they are men. But all I'm assuring you now is that he will come back to his senses. Just keep praying. Because prayer changes things. You know, girl? Go? Like, come, my daughter.
Sweetie. I can see you like the food.
Mm? That's good.
Honey, come to Mama. I can't wait.
Well, let me finish it.
No, we'll do the food later.
Wow.
I can't wait. Wait up for me.
Alright. Always watch your steps there.
Okay.
Thank you very much for the money.
Alright. It should be fine. Nothing will happen to me. Okay, guys, let's go. The taxi's out.
Well, you're too skeptical.
Yes?
Mr. Hello, Fleming. Adi. How are you?
Fine, thank you. We're just relaxing.
And to inform you that we are still working seriously on the money theft.
And my boys are
grounded on it. And the culprits must be fished out.
Thank you, Mr. Fleming. Thank you for being there. And I bless that spot where I met you.
The spot you almost killed yourself.
Please, join us.
No, I'm still on duty.
Yes, I'll be going now.
Okay.
All right. Thank you very much.
Who was that?
I tell you how I met this guy. What? Before I lose my temper now.
Oh, lose the temper. Auntie, lose your temper. Where were you last night? I was calling your phone. Did you pick up? No. Did you call me back? No. Now you are asking me where I'm coming from. Like you care?
That does not answer my question. I said, where are you coming from now?
My mother's health is becoming very bad. She's in the hospital. I need money.
Well, if it is money you want, let me tell you, I don't have one kobo.
Wait, you give me money for my mother.
What is the meaning of this?
It's money.
Get out of
here. No. Leave me alone.
Ah! Yeah, I said, get out of my way. What is wrong with you?
Listen. Kill me!
Isn't it?
What did I do to you?
Adim, what's this now? Why are you beating her?
What's the thing that I did wrong now? What did I do?
Adim.
$20,000.
Is that what a stupid man came to change?
$20,000. Money?
You know what, Money? Give him his coat. And put the rest in my drawer. I've got better things to do.
Lady G, I suspect that man knows me.
Really?
Yes, boss.
I will pretend I did not hear this. Because you know the rules. No loose ends. So, fix it.
Robbed this morning.
Jesus Christ.
Of $20,000.
Oh my God, that's terrible.
Some boys on a bike snatched my bag.
That's terrible. Jesus Christ.
Yes, the matter is already with the police, so we're going to the police right now. Yes. So, let me rush. Yes, I'll see you guys later. Hope you're in touch with your friend.
Yeah.
Okay. So, I'll see you.
Came to check if Ezinne is around. We are looking for her.
I'd like to see her.
Oh, are you? Huh?
Tell us if she's here.
I've just come to tell her that I'm sorry.
Oh, how sweet. Did you think about that when you raised your hand to beat up a girl who has given you heaven and earth?
You forget so easily. And at the slightest quarrel, you beat her up mercilessly.
Underling. I mean, this has to do with husband and wife.
Oh, don't even put your mouth in this. Don't even bother saying the words.
Let's give them the chance to settle amicably.
Oh, Kiria, you're back.
I'm taking her to the clinic. She'll find some.
Let's go.
Kira. Kira.
Kira. Isn't it? Please, just take it easy. Stop crying. Just take it easy, eh?
Maya, let's go. Let's go. Let's go.
Mama Adim, cool down. Calm down first. I will invite him here and talk sense into him.
No, Maya. I said no. I will go there and talk sense into his head. How should he do a thing like that? Why? Eh? Ule Gwalia Pwe? Why? Kiko ni se tuwa taive? Ule Gwalia? Who gave birth to... Maya, let's go.
It's not...
Mama Adim.
I'm good. Mama Adim, come back.
Don't shut up your mouth. Shut up your mouth. Adim Abba, how dare you? How dare you lay your hands on that girl?
Let us talk about it inside. Just come inside.
Inside where? Inside this house. I am not going in anywhere. I'm not going inside this house. The house you defiled by beating up your wife. Yes, I'm not going in.
Come and beg that girl. Come and beg for her forgiveness. Before I
know,
I will forgive you.
Mama, it has not even reached that level.
Yes! Yes, it has gotten to that level. And I know, my son can never be a wife beater. Not even when I'm alive. I will not take it. And if you must know, I am living.
Wait now, Mama. cannot go like that now.
What's this?
You cannot go now. Wait. Mama, wait.
Hey, come to the village and beg your wife. That is the only thing.
Mama.
Money. Oh, good day, sir.
Yes, money.
Yeah. So, you see this car parked right here? It's the key from my boss. She said she's personally hand this key over to you.
Yeah. You can't be serious.
Enjoy. One love. Yeah, it's nice meeting Thanks. You. Yeah. Have a nice day. Yeah. See you.
Wow.
Mountain doesn't go to Mohammed. Mohammed will go to the mountain.
Okay,
I
I'll
missed
come.
You.
I'll come to your house.
No, 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 no.
Hold on, man.
Good one, huh?
There's a bigger problem.
What's that?
Where do I begin to beg Ezinne from? Is it from the beating? Or the fact that she caught G2 and I red-handed?
And now, this whole issue is getting too complicated for my life.
I've really messed up myself.
Adim, I have to be very frank with you. This time around, you have to look for a way to sort this out yourself. I mean, you got yourself into this. Sort it out. You know, I have the issue of career and pregnancy to solve. I wish I could go somewhere to clear my head.
Do whatever you can to bring back your wife. I said, do all you can to bring back your wife. I will not be a party to receiving back the bride price we paid according to what the parents told us. Hey,
Adimapua, you are a disappointment. You are indeed a disappointment. Tfiakwa.
Mama, it's not that bad. Eh? I don't like the way you are taking it. I don't like it.
The same way we, your parents, do not like what you are doing to yourself.
Exactly.
How dare you bring another woman into your matrimony at home? The same day you beat your wife up. You said, Kwaku, madam?
Papa, I've told you I can sort it out by myself. Mm. Eh? I will sort it out. I don't like
Adim,
this kind
Adim,
of
thing. Adim, look at Adim, Adim, come here. Don't worry, I know exactly what to do.
Obala!
Come.
Adim, Adim,
Adim. Adim.
Crying. You have to at least take a shower and come and eat something.
I don't want to eat.
Isn't it? You will starve yourself to death. Hmm? You've done the right thing by giving that ingrate a space. Then we'll figure out how to get your money back. My mother is very, very ill. She needs to... medical attention. And there is no money. God will do it. God. Just listen to you. I have got myself into this mess. Just calm down, okay? Calm down. I'm sure by now that Chito mom must have collected all his money because she doesn't respect anything else but money.
That really cool.
Did I?
Very first day I set my eyes on him, I knew he wasn't good for you at all.
Chief, I wish I knew this really.
Well, it's not late, it's not late. I still love you and I'll always be there for you. And I thank God that he didn't even take much from you. You know, you are still... You are very self, as pretty as ever. Yes, let me say yes. Look at your equator, still very flat. And coming up to the Tropic of Cancer, where you have the headlamps, are still upright and straight to the point. And those two dots there can even perforate a tin of milk. And then coming down to the Tropic of Capricorn, where the Bacchazo is. The Bacchazo is still a comfort zone. Oh, come on, my baby. Come on. You are still. Come on, baby.
So
cool. What is it? Isn't it?
What is it? Chief, just give me the key. Where's the key?
What is all this?
his recent condition has given me so much concern. I mean, did her mother's illness, heartbreak from Adim, not having money? Ah, what do we do?
It's really an odd time for all of us. Considering you're heavy, your hands are tied. Ezinne is like a sister to us. And this is the time we need to show her love. I have this room tonight. And he's going to fetch me big. Yeah. I'll see what I can do for her by tomorrow.
God bless you.
Just let her know when to see someone when she wakes up, okay? And please take care of yourself.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
See your mother.
You can see her.
I want to see the wicked lawbreaker.
Bros, I go begin you.
My friend, I said I want to see her.
You are making a lot of noise here.
You! Wicked, good for nothing lawbreaker. A father does not seek trouble in vain. I am here to warn you. Stay clear of my son, Adim Abua. Else, I'll cross your entire generation. Don't touch me!
Shameless morals.
Guarding a cantankerous woman. If you come near again to touch me, I'll lay an irreversible curse upon you. And you, Lady G2 or G-Idiot, whatever your names are, take off your prostituting eyes of my son. Yes!
Else what? Old man.
You are the prostitute. Shameless prostitute. Akuna mwa. Akuna akuna.
Money! I have had enough.
Don't touch me, you. Look at this one! I will deal with you.
Don't you dare come any inch close to me. Because I am so pissed at you. How could you? How dare you not stop your father from coming into my house and raining insults on me?
No, listen. I don't know anything about it. I'm sure it was my wife that, you know, planned all this madness. And look, I didn't even know that my father would go to that extent of getting your address and even paying you a visit.
Look, that was a very big insult on my person and personality. Look, if he wasn't your father, I would have had his balls chopped off.
Come on. I'm really, really sorry, baby.
Look, warn him. Because if he dares, tries that with me again, huh?
Come on, you can't go now, baby, yeah? Right? Come on, huh? You can't walk out with me, you know you need to.
Look, I'm very, very pissed.
Mama G. G2.
This is serious. Ha! Are you sure someone didn't do this to you without you knowing?
I don't think so. You see, I told my wife that I had a serious assignment in Abuja. And she didn't know that the assignment was Ezinne. You see, any man who is running after women, he's pursuing either of two things. It's either he catches his phone or catches his funeral. And from the time of Samson of the Bible, more great men have perished in between the legs of women than in all the oceans of the earth.
be honest to you, something funny happened that night. Isn't she run away?
Yes, she ran away. And I was flung down like a common criminal. But my if that, everywhere.
This is mysterious.
Have you people seen Ezinne?
Because I need to know exactly what happened that night.
Chief, I advise you go home and treat yourself first. I have called Ezinne on the phone. When she comes back, we'll come to the guest house and we'll talk about it. But for now, please, go and treat yourself.
Hey, are you sure I will survive? Are you sure I will survive it?
It's
all
right, so let me go.
Okay. Papa, all these things I brought. There are some more in the car, let me just get them. I just want you to be happy again. Let me.
Adma, Abba, come here. What justification do you have to make us happy?
Adam, buying us provision and food, when your wife
that was supposed to bring us joy of grandchild is not here around you, what do you think? Ewa? Hey!
What do you do? I got that on the chacha. I got that on
the. Look, Adamaba.
Pack these things and take them away from my house. Take them away with the other ones, whatever you call them. We don't need this. Go and bring Ezinne, your wife, back.
You heard your father, didn't you?
Adam, Ogwe Nulife Nagipu, we don't need any gift from you. Don't bring us gifts! Don't! Because we are not going to take it. Until you bring your wife, Ezinne, with such gifts, then we can take it. Inane, that's all.
Good.
Take them out of this place, oh!
I will throw them out, oh!
I will throw them away. Take them out of this place.
Sugar, what did you have? What are all over your body?
I went to your house thinking you were there, and a woman opened the door and.
Yes? Who are you?
I'm Chuka, Ezinne's brother. I want to see my sister Ezinne. She inside.
Well, Ezinne, or whatever you say her name is, does not live here anymore. So I suggest you go look for her somewhere else. Right?
But this is my sister's house.
When I say get out, I mean out! Stupid. Back, we'll go together to pay my mom's bills, alright?
Alright, no problem.
Ezinne, yes?
What are you watching us? Kira, I just took me on the board. Please, could you help me give Chuka something to eat?
Okay, I'm just dashing out. I propose to be back very early. Okay.
Chuka, you're okay.
Kira, how are you?
Kira, okay.
Thank you.
I have to start going. My brother is at home waiting for me, please. I have to pay them with the money.
Okay, the money. Where's the money? Where's that faction?
Thank you.
What's that? What's going on?
No, please don't miss me. Please, really.
You before. I know. I'm so sorry. Please, find a place in your heart to forgive me. I mean, it's difficult. It's difficult for me to ignore the fact that I'm going to be the father of our baby very soon. Please.
Stop disturbing me, please.
What happened?
We
are together in the room and something happened. I was surprised. It's in the screen. And ran away. Behaving like she's going mad.
Jesus Christ, what are you saying?
What is this man saying? Kira, what is this man? I didn't hear anything. Chuka,
calm down. Please, where exactly is Ezinne now? And what happened to her?
In fact, I don't know about her, but what I'm advising people is that two people should go and look for her.
Meanwhile, I have to take my leave. Hey! Wait! Where is this man? Where is this man?
Chuka,
come on. Go away!
Don't touch me. Don't ever touch me.
Adim, what's the meaning of all this?
How could you? Huh? Did you have to go that far? Did you have to go that far?
Quit all this attitude. Go what far? What?
Did you have to make my wife mad simply because you want to add me to yourself?
What the hell? Lenny? Me, Jitu, make your wife mad. For what?
For whatever reason, I don't know. For your selfish interest.
I can't believe you stand before me to utter such nonsense, Adim.
That is extremely wicked of you. Very wicked of you, Gold. I can't even imagine that you can be such a wicked person.
Adim, please. Please. This is my house. So, get out. Get out before I call my boys to deal with you mercilessly.
I want to assure you that you haven't seen the end of this yet. Wait for me.
Get out! Me, make your wife mad! Money! Money!
What the hell is this one?
Kilia, what's this I'm hearing?
Chief is in there, or is in there, has run mad.
And we have not even found her.
Oh my God. Oh my God. It's the oath.
Fidelity is the oath. It's the oath.
What oath?
Adim made Ezinne swear an oath that if any other man touches her, she will go mad.
Oh my God.
It's the oath. It's the oath. It's the oath.
When an ant stings the buttocks, the inner chamber flies open. I've always said that that boy was not good for Ezinne. Look at all the pens. He's cursing her, the poor girl. All for marriage. Away!
I always thought that it was that woman G too, my partner. Never occurred to me. It was the old. Oh, I didn't.
Try.
Hey! Hey!
Arwen, man!
Eh? Why? I didn't need all this. It's not done so in our house here. Oh my God. It saddens my heart.
To watch such predicaments before my daughter-in-law. All because of my son's foolishness.
Well, it's okay. That's why we're all here. To see what could be done to reverse the effect of the oath.
Thank you, Chipakajak, for the information. We shall see our pastor. This is a spiritual matter. He can handle it.
Hey, Chineke, what kind of thing is this? Why would you allow this kind of thing to come near me?
Mama, it's okay, it's okay. You see, a task is only a task when there's no solution. But I want to assure you that in this matter, we're going to find a solution. I promise you.
Thank you so much, Chibakaji. You're welcome.
It's my pleasure.
We'll see our pastor tomorrow.
Why the arrest?
Madam, move. If you get to the station, you will explain better.
Exactly. I see you guys want to lose your job because you don't know me. Me, Jitu.
She does not have any outstanding bill as at the moment.
Oh, good. Just put the entire bill on me, okay? Yes, I will take care. Okay, take care of everything.
Yes. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you. It's okay. It's okay.
It's okay. You're fine now. And I'll be fine, okay?
Your wife put to bed a bouncing baby girl.
She
Man!
Look at you. Unbelievable. Man, you are now a daddy.
Marvelous, ain't it? It sure feels good to be a father, man.
I'm happy for you, man.
Me too, bro. So happy.
If only Ezinne would accept my plea for forgiveness, everything would just be okay.
Give us some time. I'm sure she's going to come around. Easy, man.
Mr. Femi.
Fidelity, I suppose.
Yes, yes, my friend.
Congratulations.
Oh!
Congratulations.
Man, it's nice to have you around. You came at the right time.
All
right. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
How are you guys
I'm
doing?
I'm doing good. All happy.
Adim, my man. That's good.
That's my suitcase. The one that was stolen with the money inside it.
An order was planned by a lady called Lady Gold. G2 for short.
Jesus Christ. Wait. The fat, beautiful lady that lives at GRA.
We kidnapped her boys. And they told us all the crimes she had been, you know, making them commit in this town. And we invaded her home. Arrested her. She's now in our custody.
This is ridiculous.
G2.
Excuse me. Are you sure about this?
You don't ask such questions. We don't do things that we're not sure of.
What? This is unbelievable.
I can't believe it.
You better believe it.
It's funny.